may endure, may last through the night, but joy comes in the morning. Amen. We may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Amen. For his anger lasts only for a moment, but his favor lasts a lifetime. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Listen, this morning, just a quick overview. We are walking in the fog. Walking in the fog. The favor of God. The favor of God. Walking. Look at your neighbor, like I've told you the last 2 weeks. Say, I'm a fog walker. I'm walking in the fog. Everywhere I go, there is the favor of God. Amen. Amen. And my working definition of favor is that God has my best interests in mind. No matter where I am, no matter what I do, God has my best interests in mind. He has my best interests in mind. Yes, even when you mess up, God can use your mess up and make it into a come up. Amen. Has there been anybody that messed up, but God uses the very thing that you were messy in, and he blesses you anyway? That's the kind of God we serve, right? You know, we say it often, he is able to turn your misery into your ministry. That's the kind of God we serve. However, there's a news alert that I gave you, and I want to continue to give you. You cannot experience the fullness of God's favor and live a life of sin. Amen. God is gracious that he will still allow you to experience his grace. But it's not until you surrender everything that you will experience the full manifestation of God's favor. Amen. I don't know about you, but I want the fullness of God's favor. I just don't want a little bit. Waking up is great. I love waking up. Thank you, God. But God, if you can give me favor throughout the rest of the day, I will appreciate that as well. Come on, is there anybody in here? Say, I want the full manifestation of God. I want the fullness. I want everything that God has to offer. Therefore, I cannot continue in a life of sin and expect for God to bless me with this fullness. That's my argument. The Bible says in Romans 6:1, what shall we say then? Shall we go on sinning so that grace may increase? Paul says, no way, by no means. No way. We are those who have died to sin. How can we live in it any longer? Whatever has died and was buried, let it be dead and buried. Amen. Let me say it again. Whatever has died and you buried it, amen, let it be dead and buried. Leave it there. Leave it behind. Amen. It will come up sometimes and pop up on your social media. And instead of accepting that thing, you got to be intentional and say, no, decline, ignore, block, amen. I don't want it in my life no longer, amen. Some of us have buried some things, but we keep taking the shovel of our emotions and digging it back up. Amen. Picking up dead stuff, amen. The pain, exhuming. God has set us free, but we're exhuming
Thank you. finish it. Listen here. I want to let you know something. I heard a song this morning. All that stuff that was on your back and you just shook it out. I want to let you know something. Now pay attention to this. All that stuff that you just took off. All of that stuff that was holding you back. I want to let you know you shook it off and it's down there now. And all that bad stuff has become your footstool. Come on, you don't want to listen to me. Just shake it off. You're going higher. Shake it off.
He knows.